My name is Ezio Auditore da Firenze. It has been 15 years since the Spaniard, Rodrigo Borgia, murdered my family and drove me into exile. Since that time I have suffered greatly, but learned a great deal more. I am an assassin, as my father and grandfathers were before me. Compelled by duty to my order, I have set aside my search for the Spaniard to recover an ancient artifact recently stolen from us. My thirst for vengeance is strong. But my responsibility to the assassins is stronger still.
Antonio's been asking for you, Ezio. You should talk to him.
Ezio, I've been singing your praises to this gentleman. He has a proposition for you.
I represent a man who has come to Venezia on a foolish errand. I fear his life is in danger, but he refuses to listen to my counsel.
And you want me to protect him?
It would ease my mind. Antonio claims you are the deadliest man in Italia.
That's true, but I am not a hired blade.
Ezio, let the man round out his request.
The gentleman I represent has organized a meeting with someone called the Spaniard.
You see, Ezio, the Spaniard has come to us.
All right, I will protect your friend, but not his business.
If that is what it takes to keep Cristofa from harm, so be it.
What is the meaning of this delay? The Spaniard promised me an hour of his time.
Apologies, Master Cristofa, but the Spaniard's plans have changed. All he requires is proof of your death.
Ah, fortune favors me. Unless you mean me harm as well.
A friend of yours sent me to guard you.
Luis Santangel. He cautioned me against this meeting, but I wouldn't listen.
How did you find the Spaniard? He isn't one to make many public appearances.
It was he who found me, actually. He caught wind of my planned expedition west and expressed a desire to fund it. This meeting was to be our first of many, but as you see, it went rather askew.
There he is! Get
him! I will draw them away. That shook them. I should be safe. As for Christopher's safety, perhaps I should check back with Antonio. The meeting was a trap.
Santangel's intuition proved correct.
It seems so. Where is he?
He asked that you meet him in the Gardens District, should anything go wrong.
I'll go, but with caution. Antonio, who are these two men?
I don't know. Santangel contacted the Thieves Guild from España. When we met, he explained his plight, and that's when I contacted you.
I'm flattered, but let's not turn this into a habit.
Thank you for all you have done.
I'm glad to see you safe, Christopher. But I am not here to further your interests. I have questions of my own.
I won't have many answers, Borgia was merely a financial opportunity. I didn't know him personally.
But you may have another chance to find him. Tell him, Christopher.
The Spaniard discovered our lodgings. Our hostel is crawling with his soldiers. They are searching for an atlas of significant worth, containing maps charting a western route to the Orient.
We are prepared to leave Italia for good, but not without that atlas. In the wrong hands, it could cause great harm.
Va bene, but this will be my final favor.
Thank you, Ezio. We will wait for your return in the harbor district.
Yeah. the assassin!
The Atlas. No mistaking that for anything else.
I found it!
There he is. Do you have the Atlas? Show it.
Take it and go. Borgia's soldiers are combing the streets.
A few maps are missing, but the Piri Reis map remains. We are satisfied.
Gentlemen, if you return to Italia in the future, bring your own protection.
We would have done so, but there are no more men in Hispania of your skill. Not since a group of assassins were imprisoned by Tomás Torquemada's Inquisitors.
Wait, what do you know of the assassins?
I am a well-connected man, Ezio, with a great number of friends. Sadly, the Inquisition has made a recent habit of arresting them.
Luis, our ship is waiting!
Be well, Ezio. May you find everything you seek.
Distressing news, Antonio. My search for the Apple of Eden will have to be postponed. I'm going to Barcelona.
I'd heard rumors of some turmoil there. What's wrong?
Sant Angel claims that a number of assassins there have been jailed. I feel it is my duty to help them.
A noble cause. I will put you in contact with my people there. They should be of some help.
Antonio gave me the names of two contacts. One of them should be able to provide me with information.
Get in!
Assassin!
Get in! There he is!
Yes, there's a thieves' guild nearby, somewhere in the center of town.
There he is! Have mercy!
Find the tallest building in town. There's a secret door on the roof.
Now my only recourse is with the Inquisitors themselves.
Of the church.
Strange to meet a gentleman leaping through these sewers. Are you on a run or just recreating?
Step aside, stranger.
You bear the mark of the assassins, and from the cut of your outfit, I'd say you were Venetian?
No, Florentine. What do you know of the assassins?
Only that I am one of them, sir. My name is Rafael Sanchez. I arrived here this morning bound to the same errand as you.
Do you know who betrayed us to the Inquisitors?
Not yet, but we know the name of the Inquisitor prosecutor responsible for their arrests, Gaspar Martinez.
I'd like to meet this prosecutor.
Good. Find me again when you're finished with him.
We can speak without interruption, Gaspar. Who gave you the names of the imprisoned assassins?
What do you mean, assassins? Our dungeons are for heretics, not medieval phantoms.
No, your purge was too systematic to be a coincidence.
Whoever these men claim to be, it won't matter after today. A public burning is about to commence for one of them, a willful young man.
If he dies, I will keep that fire burning until this town is a cinder. What's this? A list? 6 names. They may be assassins too. When Sanchez and I cross paths again, I will ask him.
Once I leave this place.
There he is, our man of action. Thank you for your help.
We got it close, Raphael, and may yet have more work. Look here, I found a troubling list.
I know these men, but they are not local. They live in Zaragoza, in the Kingdom of Aragon.
The Inquisitor carried this.
Then it is safe to assume these men are also targets.
Zaragoza will be my next stop. Will you come?
I will. Although my skills as a fighter are dwindling, I know the town well and could serve as your guide.
Stay safe, gentlemen.
Seek out the Inquisition's calificador Pedro Llorente. His tribunal meets in a building on the far side of town.
You're not coming?
Oh no, I'm too well known here. If a tragedy should befall Pedro, I'll need an alibi.
Torquemada, an unexpected but welcome visit.
I require neither your blessing nor your permission to enter here, Pedro. How is our prisoner?
A staunch one. He refuses to convert or confess.
Most who are brought here feel they have God's protection, no matter what their faith. And yet, they always tremble with fright. But you dismiss the idea of God altogether, and yet you show no fear. Remarkable. Rodrigo Borgia was right to have me arrest you and your cohorts. Your lack of faith is a disease. Let the heretic bleed.
Already dead. So it was the Spaniard himself who had these men arrested and branded heretics. I won't allow the remaining five to share this man's fate.
What name is going on here? Four escaped heretics?
Your Holiness.
You assumed the people of Zaragoza would shrug off the random imprisonment of six eminent men?
We accuse them of countless heresies, Pedro, publicly.
Your duties do not end with their imprisonment, they begin there. Whoever freed those four men will certainly be looking for the last.
Guard our prisoner at all costs, or Torquemada will personally supervise your disemboweling.
My most heartfelt thanks, stranger.
Nothing strange about me, friend. We're one and the same.
Ezio, the shadows of my city are moving again. How many of our brothers were you able to find?
5 of 6. An inquisitor named Torquemada murdered one before I could reach him.
That would be Tomás Torquemada, the king's grand inquisitor. He must be here to speak with Pedro Llorente.
I saw them together. It appears their orders to arrest the assassins came directly from Rodrigo Borgia himself.
Just as we suspected. Contact between the Templars and Inquisitors. Both these men must be stopped. Pedro will be easy to find here in Zaragoza. But locating Torquemada may take some time.
I'm a patient man, Sanchez.
What's this? You're not allowed in here?
Excuse my intrusion, but I was told you might know how to get me in contact with the Templars.
The Templars? Surely you're joking, young man. The Templars were disgraced and disbanded 2 centuries ago. Rumors of their continued activities are as reliable as fairy tales.
That's a shame, Padre. If they don't exist, they won't be able to save you. Pedro is dead, but I have neither seen nor heard any sign of Torquemada.
I guessed you wouldn't. It's a pity the Queen failed to mention to me that her dear Grand Inquisitor was in town.
You have spoken with Queen Isabella?
I work for her, Ezio, as her treasurer. While you were out freeing our brothers, I was attending a finance meeting.
An assassin embedded in the monarchy's highest ranks. Fascinating.
We have one of her ears, and it may be that the Templars have the other. Naturally, Isabella and King Ferdinand are ignorant of our infiltration. Come, I will tell you more on the road to Granada.
I have freed those I came to rescue. I should be returning to Italia.
Ezio, I beg you to stay and help me. We are on the fringe of a Grand Templar scheme. Come, I will explain. And so, spurred by their desire to see the Kingdom of Hispania united by a single faith, the Inquisitors convinced the Queen and King to drive out the remaining Moors. This is why war rages here in Granada. The Palace of Alhambra and the city surrounding it are the last Moorish strongholds on the continent.
It sounds like the battle is already won.
One would think, but for some reason the Moors continue to fight. Perhaps King Mohammed XII has a death wish. Halt! We have reached the outskirts of the city. It is a disputed territory and still quite dangerous.
What is our course?
Do a sweep of the area and eliminate all threats. We must make it safe for the civilians to move about.
Thank you.
The worst violence, but pockets of resistance remain. Bands of lawless soldiers are harassing civilians. We cannot let this city descend into anarchy. When you are certain the civilians are safe, meet me in the chapel at the center of the village.
After my wife and child. Follow me, sir, quickly.
Assassin! Stop the assassin!
Found it!
Luis Sant'Angelo? This is an unusual coincidence.
Not a coincidence at all, Ezio. Sanchez sent word that you might be joining us. We assassins run in close circles, after all.
The world is not so large as it feels, is it?
Wherever you go, you are bound to find one of us working in secret. In the court of a monarch, for instance.
Both of you work for Isabella and Ferdinand?
It has taken many years, and reluctant conversions, to gain their confidence. But it has been necessary. The king and queen are easily swayed by pious blather.
There will be time later to explain our purpose in greater detail. But we have need of your skills now. A Templar spy is passing false information to King Muhammad inside the city, encouraging him to continue the fight. Find the secret passage the spy is using before killing him.
If this war does not end swiftly, the Templars will continue to use the chaos to their advantage.
Open the gate to the catacombs.
Off to counsel King Muhammad, are you? I don't understand that fool. Why does he keep us fighting this pointless war?
Are you being insubordinate, soldier? Just open the damn gates.
Yes, sir!
The poor lad's got no idea, does he?
And it had better stay that way. If anyone knew we were prolonging the war deliberately, it would alter the Queen's tactics.
My God, you Templars convolute even the simplest plans!
Our assassin returns. Did you find the spy?
I did. I overheard him talking about keeping España embroiled in this war deliberately.
Interesting. First they see Christopher's map, then they come to España to exacerbate a war that does not concern them.
We have suspected for some time that the Templars were planning their own expedition west. This may be their way of delaying Christopher's journey.
That Atlas must contain wonders to inspire such broad schemes.
Indeed, but we will not know how true they are until Christopher has set sail, and that won't happen until this war is over.
I fear something terrible has happened to King Muhammad. He was once an ally to the Assassins, but we have not heard from him in many months. Find him if you can, if the Templars haven't already.
I'll enter through the catacombs. The Templar spy preferred that route. Explosions from above. Has the siege started again? city is under siege and everything is locked down, this won't be easy.
Assassin!
Apologize, Boabdil, for putting your beautiful city through such hardship.
I am King Muhammad of Nasrid, usurper. Untie me!
I will regret the destruction of Alhambra Palace. Unfortunately, this Spanish siege must continue until Granada is dust and the Queen is penniless.
My dislike of Isabella pales in comparison to the hatred I feel for you and your Templar stooges.
Hold on to that anger. It may comfort you in your final hours.
P.
Peace be upon you, sir. For whom do you work?
Luis Santangel sent me to find you. He assumed you were dead, or had gone mad.
I am happy to admit to neither. The assassins and I haven't always seen eye to eye, but I have been grateful for their aid over the years.
We need to end this war. As much as it may pain you, your time in España is at its end.
Too many missteps and misunderstandings to repair. Yes, I agree. What shall we do?
I will cross the city and open the gates, carrying word of your abdication. Stay here until the city has fallen silent.
War is ended, and the conciliatory King Muhammad is in a meeting with the Queen to discuss terms.
Oh, I have been waiting for this moment, Luis. Do you feel it? The tide shifting beneath us.
Patience, Cristofa. It will take some time for Isabella to entertain thoughts of spending money on you.
I have been waiting 6 years for an answer from the Queen. If she cannot indulge me now, I will indulge other offers.
Cristofa, don't be foolish. We're close.
We've been close for too long, Luis. It's now or never.
Damn him. It's too soon to go begging for money from a war-weary monarch.
Help! They need soldiers! Mobs are going to burn the city down!
Ezio, this is more Templar meddling.
Huh?
Wars never end abruptly, do they?
They never end at all, Sanchez. It just appears that way when the body count is low.
You have given us an advantage, and when we secure a mandate for Christopher's voyage, you will have given us hope as well.
My understanding is still cloudy. Hope for what, exactly?
Most men stoke their imagination of what lies beyond the ocean sea with stories of quick routes to Cipango and Cathay. But Christopher's maps tell another tale. One the Templars know quite well. Legends of an intermediate land as large as our own.
Another continent?
A new world, Ezio!
How are you holding up, Luis?
My patience is thin. Torquemada has already dispatched an Inquisitor to round up heretics for trial in Granada.
Torquemada should be arrested for these abuses. Surely the Queen would side with you if the truth were exposed.
No, she would never believe such charges. Torquemada has been Isabella's confessor since she was a young woman.
Besides, it would be unwise to allow such turmoil to disrupt our plans for Christopher.
Hold fast, gentlemen. I will try to calm this chaos.
I found him! Mercy!
Ah!
assassin!
No!
Inquisitor soldiers are out in full force, meeting out blind punishments for invisible offenses.
Ezio, find the Inquisitor in charge of this operation. Eliminate him when he is alone, in secret. Otherwise the violence will redouble, and we will lose our advantage.
I must not be seen anywhere near this man's body. Patience. Thank you.
queen let the Moor king live? Isabella's heart is not hard enough to do lasting good for España. When the time is right, I will give her counsel. España must be unified. One people, one faith. Until then, Tomás? Round up all who do not profess allegiance to the Pope and expel them. If they resist, you are free to do as you will.
Yes, Tomás. God be with you.
And you, Juan de Mario, may he guide your every step.
Round up your best men and prepare for a sweep of the city.
Sant'Angel, who is our guest?
I am Ezio Auditore, a Florentine by birth, and a wayfarer by trade.
He is a friend, Queen Isabella. It was Ezio who brokered King Mohammed's surrender.
Ezio Auditore, it seems the whole of España owes you a great debt.
I wonder if Cristoforo Colombo might profit a little from my royal largesse.
I wish I could vivify his withering dream. But our funds are still scarce. Take comfort knowing that the King of France has made him a recent offer.
He cannot be serious.
Well, he certainly thought it was genuine. He left for Paris this morning.
Oh, that fool! Ezio, he is still in great danger.
I will find him.
Bring him back here and tell him the Queen has had a change of heart.
I found him!
You're in great danger.
Do not interfere, Ezio. I've had quite enough counseling from your quarter.
There he is!
Has the world gone so mad that a simple adventurer cannot go but a few weeks without being attacked in the street?
Christopher. You are no simple adventurer.
Unfortunately, only you and the King of France recognize this.
King Charles hasn't the metal to back you. This is a Templar trick.
Have you any proof of your outrageous claim?
I don't need any. Sant'Angelo has assured me that Isabella has had a change of heart.
Good God, how I loathe these games. Lead the way, Ezio.
A fascinating proposal, Luis. And one I would gladly accept were Christopher to return.
And return he has. What's the good news?
Inspiring words and a few bags of coin have changed the Queen's mind. Prepare to set sail, Christopher.
How many bags of coin did it require?
Your friends have agreed to cover half the total costs, Christopher.
Praise you, Luis, you fine and gracious man.
Soon we will be praising you, my friend, for all the wonders you will find and report to the world.
But let all rejoicing wait until we have seen your cross trees dip below the horizon.
Yes, Sant'Angelo. Caution. Yours has saved me from myself more times than I should admit. Come, gentlemen, let us celebrate!
I just received word. Christopher has set sail from Palos with three ships and his precious Atlas.
I am honored to have helped you all, and wish I could be here to welcome him home. But conflicts of my own now draw me back to Italia.
Of course. The search for your stolen artifact continues.
Luis, you must hide. Torquemada has dispatched guards to arrest you.
Contemptible man. He already forced a conversion from me. Now I suspect the Templars are feeding him orders.
Revenge for spoiling their war, I suppose. Stay here, Luis. I'll handle this.
Stop the assassin!
No arrest. They intended to murder me. I'm certain they will be after Sanchez in due course.
I won't let that happen.
Once Sanchez is safe, find Torquemada and bring him to justice.
Is that wise? You said yourself that Torquemada was off limits.
Just use your best judgment, and let no one see you.
Mercy.
You have a knack for timing. 1 minute more and I've been dead. Or worse.
Oh, we riled up the Templars and now they're openly sending Inquisitors to imprison us.
Revenge by proxy. It's time to find Torquemada and end this.
Before you do anything rash, make him talk. Find out how close to the Templars he really is.
vile and pitiful man, Torquemada. And your alliance with the Spaniard has disqualified you from your god's love.
You dare to lecture me? I am the hammer of heretics, the light of España, the honor of my order. I follow none but God's command.
All lies. Rodrigo Borgia is an unbeliever like me, and yet you lavish him with favors.
A fantastic tale, and a spurious one. Borgia is one of three papal candidates this year, and he is as devoted to God as I am.
There's no better hiding place than in the shadow of virtue. You are as blind to his evil as you are to yours.
So what will you do with me, heathen? Murder me? Slit my throat and bathe in my blood?
No. I prefer a quick, clean kill.
Guards!
You will discover the truth about Rodrigo Borgia in time. But by then, it will be too late. Forgive me, my friends. Torquemada escaped. But not before enlightening me on one or two points. He is a petty man, consumed by self-deception.
What of his connection to the Spaniard?
He admires Rodrigo Borgia, but I do not believe Torquemada is a Templar himself. Merely a credulous old sycophant. Perhaps this is for the best. Torquemada's death would have caused more turmoil than it ended.
We will work hard to distance him from the Queen, while we protect ourselves from his inquisitors.
Best of luck, my new friends. And send me word when Christopher returns.
He has promised to write me the moment he arrives. I will forward the copy of any letter he sends.
I look forward to it.